So, did you find a couple of blokes have got your back?
Actually, I did.
Great. Are you ready to move forward then? Remember, once you make this decision, you can't go back and change your mind. Besides, there's no time for that with your championship deadline approaching, so you better be absolutely certain.
I like the faction I've put together. It's the right group of guys to help neutralize Shawn Michaels and my old crew so I can take down Slade.
I hope you're right, for your sake.
The Hurt Business has arrived in style to Monday Night Raw.
Whoa!
The Hurt Business is getting ambushed.
They were not expecting this.
MVP into the side of the limo.
There's broken glass everywhere.
We've heard rumors that a new faction was forming to take on the Hurt Business, and this must be it.
And Braun Breaker's tossed headfirst into the limo.
This is pure chaos.
Not so fun now that I've evened up the sides, is it? I'm coming for this title, and there's nothing you can do to stop me.
Now what?
I think they're gonna flip over the limo. This is insane.
Making an impact. The Hurt Business, Shawn Michaels, and all of WWE, for that matter, has been put on notice.
I can't believe this group that's been assembled.
This next month is going to be very interesting.
So far, so good. I knew you'd make a great leader. Also, I'm enjoying a new bus. I could get used to this.
Don't get too comfortable. If things don't work out for me, the bus goes along with everything else.
Fair enough. Well, more motivation, I guess. You think you're ready for the big match later tonight?
We already dominated them once tonight. The match will just be more of the same.
I like your confidence, but don't get carried away. You have to expect Shawn Michaels is gonna strike back. Be careful.
We got this.
New faction in WWE is ready for their in-ring debut.
The following contest is a six-man tag team match. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 794 pounds, Hillbilly Giant Bobby Turner, The Rock, and Drew McIntyre.
We've already seen what this crew can do in a parking lot, but this is our first real look at their in-ring chemistry.
The former Lock worked tirelessly to put this group together. Let's see if the hard work pays off. No traces of their parking lot pounding in that Hurt Business swagger. They're ready.
And their opponents, at a combined weight of 709 pounds, Slade MVP and Braun Breaker.
Former Lock's brand new faction has already put the Hurt on the Hurt Business once, but this match will be a taller order.
And the orders don't get much taller than Slade, Braun Breaker, and MVP.
A stunning attack earlier tonight that sent shockwaves through WWE. The former Lock leads his two new allies against his previous faction in a dramatic three-on-three match.
Do you hear that, Cole? That's the sound of the SummerSlam deadline getting closer and closer. The new faction leader can't afford to lose any ground against the Hurt Business.
And I bet Slade and company would love nothing more than to crush their former teammates' momentum, not to mention paying back for that little visit in the parking garage. Oh, my God! That'll stop anybody.
He gets tagged in.
The Rock in with the tag.
With the lariat.
Oof! Big time clothesline.
Good grief.
Step ahead of The Rock. He turns it around.
Oh my, he's going for the pin.
Looking to steal one there, perhaps.
Love the confidence, but it's a little early for that.
Nice counter from Breaker.
Big time clothesline.
Good grief.
Oh, stiff kick. Ooh.
answer for The Rock. Boom! Right between the eyes.
Oh, meet the backside of an elbow.
Getting set up for something in the corner. The Rock is heading up top.
Up high!
In off the tag. Knee right to the gut. He's returning fire. McIntyre reverses and looks to capitalize.
Big punch by the Hook.
Oh, God. He's lost some of his win now. That one's scouted. These two show how well scouted they each are. Sharp punch. Boom. Knife edge chop. And going through the arena.
Ooh-wee. Now trampling the opposition.
Ooh, slows that down with a well-placed kick.
MVP looking. Solid punch. And there he goes, a perfectly placed target. Whoa! He had it scouted.
Into a DDT.
Kick to the gut.
Oh, brutal form. Oh.
And out of the ring he goes. Oh, took off the hook.
Sad intentions in mind.
Here, come on, Byron, get in front of me.
No!
And he throws the opposition back into the ring. McIntyre turns things around. Belly. He's getting a little battered now. Power from the suplex.
Just another insane display of power.
To the midsection. Able to sidestep it.
Sequence of reversals there.
And he's already taken more hits up there than he should have to handle.
Able to capitalize. is a McIntyre's mistake. Face buster! And MVP has taken control.
Yeah, MVP has his opponent figured out.
Now this is a textbook example of how to bend the rules.
Using the forearm to their advantage.
And this is just a vulgar display of ruthlessness. Oh, look at this ruthlessness in the bottom turnbuckle.
Here's the cover for the win. And the ref can't even start the count.
Truly cannot vote.
Close.
Oh, Lord.
So effective.
MVP fends that off. And he's asking for more.
Ooh. And Slade gets stonewalled.
Back and forth from these competitors.
Yes, press! Oh, strong impact. Tag made, tag made.
And now, guys, this is a very concerning development. Referee needs to examine the situation.
Now this is the result of constant attacks to the torso area.
Axe bomber! Wait a second. What's Evolution doing out here?
They're attacking the Hurt Business's opponents? But why?
This is turning into a 5-on-3 beatdown. Running power slam into the ring post. You have got to be kidding me.
Evolution has officially joined forces with the Hurt Business. Unbelievable.
Don't you just love it when a plan comes together? Or, in this case, two of the most powerful factions in WWE. I mean, just when you thought you had evened up the sides, we were two steps ahead. So, good luck winning the championship, saving your career now.
And the WWE Champion nails the Slade Runner.
The Hurt Business started this night on their heels, but now we end the night looking at a brand new super group led by Shawn Michaels, more powerful than anything we've ever seen before.
You have to feel for the former Lock, who looked to have captured momentum in his quest to win gold and remain in WWE, but now he has suffered a major setback.
Let's be real, guys. This is more than a setback. It's a career-ending roadblock.
We've seen him overcome long odds before, but I agree. This does not look good.
Tough night out there. We'll catch up back at the bus. What do you want?
Just came to check on you and let you know that it's over. You lost.
It's not over yet. I still have time.
Maybe. But how do you think you're gonna get another WWE Championship match? I hold all the cards.
I have a proposal. Next week, I'll take on someone from your new supergroup. If I win, I get a title match at SummerSlam with a chance to beat the deadline.
And if you lose?
Then we can forget about the deadline. I'll leave WWE immediately.
So, basically, if things go our way, and they will, I can get rid of you sooner than I planned? I like the sound of that. You have yourself a deal.
So who am I gonna face next week?
Let's keep that a surprise. But I will give you a heads up on one thing. The match is gonna be no disqualification. So good luck stopping us.
It's the superstar who's fighting for his life in WWE.
The following is scheduled for 1 fall, making his way to the ring from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing in at 275 pounds, Hillbilly Giant Bobby Turner.
With a win, the former Rock gets exactly what he needs. A WWE Championship match versus Slade. And right at Shawn Michaels' SummerSlam deadline.
But a loss sends him packing from WWE forever. Hopefully Tavish has a spare couch ready.
A SummerSlam door is about to open or slam right in his face.
After an inspirational return to WWE. The former Lock is risking everything to keep his dreams of a WWE Championship match alive against Bron Breakker.
Call it a cliche, but the stakes are absolutely through the roof. A no disqualification match with no future in WWE if he can't break the Breakker.
On the flip side, if he can't find a way to beat the big man, the former Lock will earn his long-awaited title match against Slade with a chance to beat the Deadline at SummerSlam. What a night.
Out of the ring, what's his plan here? He's feeling the effects of that last hit.
Kick to the gut.
Uh-oh. And he's able to reverse. Thrown out of ringside and back to the mat.
Oh, man, Breakker just got busted up.
Look out! Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here?
Roundhouse kick, man. Takedown, and now punches right.
Oh my goodness!
Just strike it at will.
Constant pressure being kept on Braun.
Every form of offense Breakker attempts is being neutralized.
He's looking for something. This could get dangerous. He's absorbing some tough hits now.
There's been plenty of action in this match, and the cost of that is really showing now.
Coming back in the ring.
Chair to the gut, softening him up.
Braun's opponent is taking advantage of this no disqualification match.
Shawn Michaels is here to also take advantage of the lack of rules.
Michaels is calling in the cavalry.
This is going to be a repeat of last week. How can anyone stop this supergroup?
But where are they?
That's one way to stop them. Have your faction take them out before they can get to you.
Smart move by their leader, but can he capitalize and win this match?
Randy Orton's here, and he has no idea.
Low blow from Orton.
The Viper's lining up an RKO.
And just a reminder, this is all perfectly legal.
Wait, what? Where did he come from?
That's international star Chosen. It looks like the former Lock had an ace up his sleeve.
But Bron Breakker has recovered, and he's got a kendo stick.
Oh, he reverses.
Now he's battering Bron Breakker repeatedly with that kendo stick.
Wait, is he setting up Bron Breakker for his own move?
And he locks it in with the kendo stick.
Can Bron Breakker hold on?
He can't. Bron tapped! It's over!
And more importantly, he lives to fight another day and will take on Slade for the WWE Championship at SummerSlam.
Somehow he found a way to pull this out, and now he has an opportunity to strike before the championship or bust deadline expires.
We'll see about that. But Shawn Michaels and company can't be pleased with how this turned out. They thought they were putting this all to an end, and instead, the fate of this man and the WWE Championship will be decided at SummerSlam.
Big win out there, but bloody hell, you didn't think to tell me about Chosen?
I thought about it, but then I also thought it'd be more fun to pull a Tavish on you.
Not the same. You don't know how to do a Tavish.
Either way, I couldn't risk it getting out. We needed any advantage we could get against them.
Well, that's not what I wanted to talk about. I have a message from WWE management.
What does Shawn Michaels have to say for himself now?
No. Not Shawn. This came directly from the top. all this faction warfare has been big for ratings, so they want to see it continue. There will be a faction versus faction match to determine who gets to pick your stipulation at SummerSlam. Our side against Shawn's. War Games.
We've already been in a battle. I guess now, it's time to go to war.
Did you see I'm the number one trending topic? What a WWE debut for Chosen.
Yeah, that's great. But more importantly, you helped me live to fight another day. So thank you.
Well, I've been watching you get beaten up so much, and you seem so desperate when you reached out asking for help that it was kind of a no-brainer to come save you.
Yeah. Well, thanks again, I guess. Anyway, I don't know if you heard what Tavish said.
I was standing 5 feet from him. Of course I had. Your tour bus is kind of small, actually.
Noted. Point is, I need one more team member for the War Games match. You interested in sticking around?
Of course. Have to keep the buzz going on social media. And to help you too.
All right. Let's do this.
The following is a men's War Games match. The rules of the match are as follows. Two teams will be contained in separate cages, with one member of each team starting the match. At regular intervals, alternating members from each team will be released to enter the match. The team with the advantage will be the first to have a member released into the match. Once all competitors have entered, War Games officially begins. The match can be won by pinfall or submission. Exiting the cage will result in a forfeit. Now, let the War Games begin!
Every war needs a hero, and you might be looking at him. It's the former Lock.
Introducing first, from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing in at 275 pounds, Hillbilly Giant Bobby Turner.
After everything he's been through, I'm starting to think this man is indestructible.
Well, there's nothing like the chaos and carnage of War Games to test that theory, Saxton.
The WWE Champion, and he's ready for war. It's Slay
and from Columbus, Ohio, weighing in at 220 pounds, the WWE Champion, Slade.
There's nothing playful about tonight's War Games, Corey. It's pure warfare.
Especially if you're facing off against Slade and the nightmarish battalion around him. Slade looks primed to continue his career-changing momentum.
I didn't think it was possible, but the road to SummerSlam keeps getting hotter and hotter, adding explosive twists and turns every week.
And incredible athletes like Japanese Phenom Chosen, who's suiting up alongside the former Lock tonight in one of the most anticipated War Games matches in WWE history.
My question, is Chosen even allowed to compete in WWE?
All's fair in love and War Games, Saxton. Both forces are clearly willing to do whatever it takes with the WWE title match's stipulation hanging in the balance. Let the games begin.
Thinks he had.
And he could have had a three count in hand. I got to question this decision.
Whoa, not quite yet. Oof. There's some power behind that punch.
Right to the chest and then the throat. Wicked.
With the reversal.
Set up in the corner of the ring. Just been tossed aside into a new terrain. And in just a moment, the numbers advantage set to come into play here. The holding cage has been open, and we're about to see a bit of a handicap match here, gentlemen. Oh, shot right to the kidney. And again.
Great way to wear out your opponent. Climbing into the ring, pretty much entering a war zone.
Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Ooh, pinpointing the trachea.
Full Nelson applied.
Yes, Dragon Suplex.
Close fist connects.
Oh, man.
Ooh, what a damaging blow. He just got sent flying into the opposite ring. Submission forces the tap out.
Freed from the cage, and now needs to make haste to even up the fight.
And that one misses the mark.
The Rock with some good timing here.
With the cage door closing, this match is now an even playing field. DDT!
And he keeps his focus on an attack to that area.
Big forearm.
Thunderous club comes down. Very effective.
He's headed up.
Might be going toward the top of this War Game structure.
And nobody's there.
Big blow could be felt throughout the arena.
Serious offense.
with that this time.
Textbook fireman's carry takeover.
Neckbreaker.
Countdown's on and get ready because this will get one to a greater number of combatants.
They are looking to punish their opponent further, and here we are.
Freed from the cage and heading toward the ring to give their team the upper hand.
Loving blow. Searching out the ring now. This can't be good.
Things are no longer about to be even in this one, and he wants to make sure of that. And now having to deal with that weapon is like going up against two competitors at once. The situation.
He begins to climb the wall of the War Games cage. Oh, the reversal by Grace.
No.
He misses on the springboard.
I think that impact might have left a crater in this arena.
Bam. Arm control applied and a kick right to the midsection.
Hauled himself up.
Time to flip it.
To jump off the top of the cage.
I think that was decided before ever reaching the top, Saxton.
Things will get back to an even plane.
Oh, we're on the cover.
I'm gonna tap out here, but it ain't gonna matter.
It's gonna do a lot of damage, though.
Gotta minimize the damage now. Go help your teammates immediately.
And look at this. Come on, come on.
The battlefield has awaited them.
Makes him pay with a counter.
Is it hard to the ropes?
Blackjack. Damian Priest would like to be your guy south of heaven.
Is that enough for Priest?
And The Rock is really being pushed to the limit.
The Rock has to find a way to navigate through all this.
The shoulders
down in a hurry.
Catching an elbow to the side of the face.
And that was a well-executed attack. Oh, did you hear the impact?
Clothesline.
He's setting this table up and got it. Someone's about to have a really bad night.
Ooh, talk with the suplex.
And Slade gets stonewalled. We've got a numbers advantage incoming as the countdown is about to run out. And some effective offense with that one.
Punching through the table. The table and the body getting well acquainted there.
Only imagine the damage that impact just did. I doubt this will go on for much longer.
Waistlock. No.
My goodness.
Punch right in the head.
Shinbreaker. He's already bringing the numbers advantage, but he wants something more. Wiped out with the crossbody. Oh, what a kick.
An elbow lands hard.
Elbow drop.
Right the shoulder. Great counter.
He's carrying some serious equipment into the cage with him, ready to fully exploit the numbers game.
Ouch. And he has to start protecting himself from attacks to that area.
Things could get ugly.
To the box.
Tap all you want, but in this case, a surrender does not grant you a reprieve. Launched his opponent. Your hand belly to belly.
Oh my goodness.
We are witnessing a malicious strike attack right now.
These are the kind of attacks that completely throw off the equilibrium.
Competitor to even the odds.
shoulder. It's a very effective and vulnerable spot. Ouch. Number's about to be.
Fading.
Well, this isn't going to win the fall, but it's going to do a lot of damage.
They're not going to go into this one without a little backup in their corner.
It all comes down to this. Win the title at SummerSlam, and you're golden. Set for life, probably. Lose? Well, you're finished. Done. Ruined. Gone forever.
What happened to the Tavish who once told me there was an entire world of wrestling outside of WWE?
I'm trying a different approach. Is it working?
Not really.
All right. Have you decided what type of match you're gonna pick? Because I was thinking, you should choose the safe match.
As in, like, the safe choice? I'm not sure what that would even be.
No, I mean a new match type I came up with called a safe match. You win by locking your opponent in the safe that you had in your WWE debut. Everything comes full circle. It's called long-term storytelling, mate. Do you love it?
I'm not sure.
Well, if you can't make up your mind about the match type, we at least need to know who's going to be in your corner. The faction started a pool on who you're going to pick. Go with Chosen, and drinks are on me.
I'm going with Chosen. And not for the free drinks. I've had all the momentum since he came in, and I want to keep that going at SummerSlam.
I'll be out there with you in spirit. And Speaking of spirits, I'm going to collect my pool money and hit the pub. I'll save you a seat.
It's been a bit, but here we are, wrapping things up with SummerSlam approaching.
You mean you're not going to follow me around the rest of my career?
Everything has to come to an end. I mean, I know viewers think they want a super long story that goes on and on forever, but really, isn't something shorter with an actual ending better? It's like you have this cool experience, and then you can go watch something from the women's division, right? Anyway, we're getting off track. SummerSlam's in LA, of all places.
Ugh. I know. It's a chance at redemption on so many levels. I'm back in the main event, but instead of a bunch of empty seats this time, we're the biggest thing in town and it's sold out. It feels good.
What about the match stipulation, though? I might be reading into this too much, but are you putting off making a decision because it means the match is officially here, and if you lose, you'll be faced with leaving WWE?
I hadn't thought about it like that, but maybe you're right. There is a small part of me that knows, despite how hard I've worked to get here, that it could all come to an end. And that's scary.
Makes sense. But what are you going to choose? You're going to have to announce it sooner than later.
If you have to know, I'm going to make it a British rules match. It's what got me back on track after I was fired, and as far as I know, Slade's never been in one. It could be a huge advantage.
Solid choice. And if this is it, well, it's been fun. And weird. Mostly fun, though. Hope to see you around. Around here, I mean.
Yeah. You too, Kat.
So final thoughts heading into SummerSlam. Will you walk away champion and end your former friend's WWE career? Or will he somehow overcome the odds and beat the deadline?
Are those the type of questions you typically ask? If so, I'm glad I haven't wasted my time doing more of these. But if you need an answer, The Lock is going to be looking for a job after SummerSlam. And let's get one thing straight. We were never friends. But I will take this opportunity to thank him. See, if he hadn't been such a failure and blown every opportunity that was handed to him, I might not be where I am today. So thanks for that.
Confident, despite the fact that you didn't get to even choose the match stipulation.
I don't care what kind of match it is. It could be a blindfold match, a lumberjack match, or a freaking padlock on a pole match for all I care. They all end the same. I win.
Hey, we're on a tight schedule, so we need to make a call one way or another.
Understood.
No idea why Shawn Michaels' supergroup is assembled here, but I guess we're about to find out.
Slade, I know this might be a bit uncomfortable, but it's time to do what we discussed. Bear with us. We have some business to take care of.
What is going on here?
I have a bad feeling about this.
I know we talked this over, but now that we're out here, it doesn't feel right.
Slade, we've been over this already. Just do the right thing.
I can win the match at SummerSlam. Just give me the chance.
It's been decided. We're going with Randy instead. So let's take care of this before it gets any more awkward.
I know I can get the job done.
I really didn't want to do this in front of the entire world. But if you need me to explain why you can't get the job done, then I will. For starters, the night The Lock returned to WWE, you overruled me by facing it. And then I had to intervene to save your championship. Or how about the time you got beat down backstage, which allowed this SummerSlam match to even happen in the first place? Or more recently, when our factions battled in war games, you lost, allowing the opposition to choose the championship match stipulation. So, if you're not picking up on it, there's a common theme with you lately: losing. But we're not about to lose the most important match in WWE history. But you know who's all about winning and is a proven commodity? The Viper Randy Orton. So Slade, do what you've done your entire career. Be a team player and fall in line.
I was not expecting to see this tonight.
Me neither. This is flat out wrong.
It's either that, or we'll make the decision for you.
Don't do it, Slade. Come on.
You're better than this.
No. He's going to do it.
This is absolutely disgusting. What a farce.
And here comes the referee to count the pinfall. What a joke.
And Randy Orton is your new WWE champion. Unbelievable.
I never thought we'd see a WWE championship change hands like this, but here we are.
I'm in shock too, but let's not forget the main event of SummerSlam has just been drastically altered. The challenger has game planned to face Slade, but will now be up against a much different opponent in Randy Orton.
I agree, Corey. Beating the deadline was going to be difficult, but it just got significantly harder in my opinion.
Thank you.
What do you want? Here to pull another last-minute swerve?
No, actually the opposite. I'm proposing a gentleman's agreement. I'll be in Randy's corner and you have your backup and yours. But let's agree to keep the others out of this. No one else from either side gets involved in the match.
And you expect me to trust you?
I'm not sure I can trust you either, but that's how these things work.
Where is this even coming from?
Our two sides have battled enough leading up to this. It's time to settle it in the ring, one-on-one. And after we made the switch to Orton, I was confident we could do that. He doesn't need any extra outside help. Do you?
No, I don't. But if you're trying to play some kind of 11th-hour mind games, it's not going to work. I'm taking your paper champion's title tonight.
We won't have to wait much longer to find out, will we? See you out there.
You know, this last-minute switch to Orton actually reminds me of the time I was supposed to face the British Bulldog on WCW Saturday night, but then his dog bit him, so I ended up facing Vader instead.
But you rolled with the punches and ended up getting the win?
Oh no, it completely threw me off and I ended up losing in like 45 seconds.
Again, you really need to work on your pep talks.
To be fair, you've had a better part of a week to prepare, while I only had about an hour. It's much different.
I hope so.
It is different. And you are too. I've known that since the first time I ever saw you. You had it. As something special that can't be taught, as separated you from the rest. Sure, there's been setbacks along the way, but they've only made you stronger and prepared you for this very moment. And now that you're at the finish line, they go and move it somewhere else. Big deal. You'll cross that line too. It's what you do. Now go out there and win the bloody match.
That was a lot better.
Ah, you think so? I thought maybe it's a bit much.
No, but the time for talking is over. Like you said, now I just need to go out there and win the damn match.
The following contest is a British Rules match and is for the WWE Championship!
It's the man who's here to beat the deadline.
between the former Rock and the WWE Championship he's wanted for so long.
Don't forget Shawn Michaels, Saxton. He's got just as much to lose as anybody. Nobody's got more to lose than the challenger, Corey. This could be his final match in WWE. SummerSlam victory to his resume tonight. It's time for a new chapter in WWE, but only one of these larger-than-life superstars will write it. Ring that bell.
Introducing the challenger from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing in at 275 pounds, Hillbilly Giant Bobby Turner. And his opponent from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 250 pounds, he is the WWE Champion, the Viper.
The stakes could not be any higher. It is time for our WWE Championship match.
The chaotic road to SummerSlam has all led to this. One of the most anticipated matches in WWE history for the WWE Championship.
But it's more than that, Cole. It's a match between a WWE superstar who left to find himself and came back to win a WWE Championship, and a living legend looking to cement his legacy as one of WWE's all-time greats.
And don't forget the greats joining them, like Hall of Famer Shawn Michaels, who has as much to lose tonight as anyone.
Well, I'd much rather lose my pride than my job, which is what the challenger's looking at if he loses tonight's British Rules match.
No matter how you look at it, this one's huge, and it's happening here at SummerSlam right. Orton ducks the strike.
And he counters with a headlock backbreaker.
Vintage Randy Orton.
Orton's clearly in control now.
It looks like he's trying for a top rope hung DDT.
His opponent's doing everything he can to counter.
And here comes Shawn Michaels with the assist.
But Shawn gets taken out.
And now the challenger has an opening.
Orton charges.
Drop toe hold into the corner.
Meanwhile, all hell is broken loose at ringside.
It looks like they'll no longer be a factor in this match.
This is now truly one-on-one.
Or is it? Slade is here. What happened to the gentleman's agreement?
It's out the window, clearly.
The challenger's in big trouble here.
Ooh, KO on Randy Orton! What the hell?
Did that just happen?
Apparently Slade hasn't gotten over being replaced.
And that could be enough to end this.
Orton kicks out.
I thought that was it.
So did the challenger, but it's going to take a lot more than that to put away the Viper.
Big boot!
Jeez. Champ taking the worst end of the exchange.
Full Nelson applied.
Face buster!
Vicious right forearm.
Oh, what a clubbing blow.
He's able to sidestep there.
Charring European uppercut.
Can Orton withstand this attack?
Orton needs to return to his instincts.
DDT!
And he has to start protecting himself from attacks to that area.
Target acquired and destroyed.
Into the cover!
Oh, the champ narrowly kicks out.
Somehow, some way, he is still in this.
A bear hug, squeezing the breath out of them.
The Viper is in serious danger.
Randy Orton's nowhere to go.
And he may have felt his grip slipping, so he releases the hold. Still was able to produce some considerable damage, though.
Orton getting worked on right now.
And Orton needs to bring the match back to his pace.
Oh! Is it enough? The cover!
Oh! Randy Orton, the apex predator.
A Viper looking unstoppable.
Vintage Orton.
Not allowing that to go on any longer. Punch right in the head. The champ has been taken to their limit.
Yeah, he's got to dig deep and find another.
A bear hug, squeezing the breath out of tap out.
He did it. Not only is he the new WWE champion, but he beat the Deadline and is officially here to stay.
The victory celebration, but Shawn Michaels is back, maybe to do that exact thing.
It's over. You lost. Just give the man his due for once.
That looks to be a small sign of respect from Michaels to the new champ.
Maybe they can finally put all this behind them and move on.
Much of the criticism he faced earlier in his career centered around his inability to work with others. So it was fitting that tonight it came down to just him and Orton in the ring, one-on-one. No one else to rely on but himself.
What the heck? That's Sami Zayn!
The new champion was just blindsided with the Money in the Bank briefcase.
Is Sami cashing in?
He is! It's official!
We have a second impromptu WWE Championship match at SummerSlam.
I can't believe this is happening.
He beat the Deadline, but he might not walk out of here champion.
Buckle up, everybody, because we might be witnessing one of the most electrifying cash-ins in WWE history at one of the craziest SummerSlams of all time.
Sami Zayn has shocked not only the brand new WWE champion, but he's shaken the WWE universe to its core.
Myself included, could somebody please put my jaw up off the floor so I can call this match?
You're on your own, Corey. It's Sami Zayn versus the newly minted WWE champion for the title right now.
Belly to belly suplex.
The challenger eating up some damage.
Charring European uppercut.
Well scattered reversal there.
Devastation.
All right, here we go.
Inside DDT.
Lights out.
Nice amateur takedown.
All the way over.
He gets sent down to the floor.
Look at him totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
He leaves the ring, but he could lose this match by countout. And he slides him back to the mat. Here's Zayn sent flying. And he's taking this to the outside now. Coming back into the ring, back to the action.
Inelegant exit, but if it works, it works.
Oh my, apron senton.
The challenger is in some big trouble.
This is a very dangerous situation now.
Sami Zayn needs to dig down deep as he's done so many times in the past.
Don't go over here.
Cole, quick, use Saxton as a human shield.
Treating the torso to yet another attack.
Just like that, he's sent crashing to the floor. He heads outside. Countout's legal in this match. Zayn able to adapt. Oh, look at this.
I don't want to be part of these problems. Don't want to be part of this crowd.
Gets him with the counter. Whip, but Sammy reverses.
Oh, the newly minted champion hit hard.
And Sami Zayn looks to capitalize. He's setting up for the Huluva kick.
This could be it.
He moved. He dodged the Huluva kick.
With the roll up. That will do it. He successfully defended his WWE Championship after Sami Zayn's shocking cash in.
Sami Zayn can't believe it. He thought he picked the perfect moment to cash in.
There goes Sammy. Thanks for coming out.
And now the Champions faction has come out to congratulate their leader.
We talked about how the champion wanted to do everything himself when he first got to WWE, but he wouldn't be experiencing any of this if he hadn't learned to be part of a team and eventually lead one.
Some of these men may now be looking for an opportunity to face the new champion, but for tonight at least, it's time to soak this all in and enjoy the moment.
And there you see Slade, who had his share of ups and downs with the new champion after being dropped in the title match tonight, but still making his presence known. He may also be looking for redemption, but for now, it seems as if he's willing to give his former ally the respect he deserves.
Good, because I don't think we or our champion can withstand another impromptu match. Let the man celebrate. He's earned it.
He certainly has, Corey. Thank you once again for joining us at SummerSlam. Good night, everybody.
Was he stubborn? Definitely. Like right up there with the best of them, including yours truly. And things definitely didn't go as planned. I mean, I haven't been in management for too long, but even I know it's not the intention to fire a top prospect and then go to war with them after they forced their way back into WWE. But at the end of the day, we trusted the process and the results speak for themselves. He lived up to his potential, didn't he? We said he was a future champion, and now he is. We weren't wrong. Did he color outside the lines a bit on his way there? Yes. But that's what the best artists do, and I respect that. I really do.
Sorry, but I wasn't actually recording yet. Do you mind saying all of that again?
Mm-hmm.